Mandirs, it's time to change. It's time to change your mandirs. Our wedding mandir officials, pandits and all that should guide people in love. They should be trained for it. Understand, they have to know the legality of interfaith marriage. Let me give you one example. Very sad story. Page 185. This Chetna Shiva Bhakta, until her late age, she never dated anybody, never had sex with anybody. She was clean. She got in love with a Muslim guy and she said, look, I cannot do all those things. So after a long convincing, she says, okay, you have to first get married and then only we could go further. So this Chetna and this Muslim guy got married in a Hindu Shiva temple because it was worth it. A Hindu Muslim came and he came with three other Muslim friends and her mother, and Panditji did the puja and they got married. Now they are married and walk out. Right away she realized that this marriage was just a way to take her to bed. Nothing more. In 3 months, he forced us beating and all that, and ultimately she had to convert to Islam. I asked her that, wait, you had a marriage, so why don't you have any proof? She says, I have all those photos, but photos somehow he got hold of it and he burned all those photos. So he does the. I said, but the mandir official, the Panditji who did it, did he document anything? He says, Panditji just took the dakshina, blessed us and done it. Nothing more. What Panditji should have done is document, take this, get a notarized and register Hindu marriage in, I think you are tired, probably this one is tired too. Register Hindu marriage in according to Hindu Marriage Act in India. Then he did not do it. So what I'm saying, the priest failed to protect an innocent Hindu girl. And who is to blame? We all to be blamed. We need to change it. Versus if any Christian marries in a church, the church goes through so much procedures. You have to go and spend 1 week there, whole day. You have to take a week off from your work and they train you exactly what you're getting into. And it's so noble things. So you're not naive what you're getting into. Islam, they're upfront and honest. You've got to convert. And they make it clear that it's converting is not a fake one. You have to be 0% Hindus, 100% Muslim. Are we preparing our own youths for interfaith marriage and for wedding? So continuing further, in mandirs, we should reduce the rituals as much as it may hurt you. And we should have more sermons where people understand what we're trying to say rather than just go through the rituals. As much as we love Sanskrit and Hindis, we should increase the use of English. Because if we are an audience, if you are talking about next generation, we have to have it. Involve children. It really hurts my heart when I see in mandir some puja, like some going on, and some kids are playing and giggling and all that. And everybody looks, shh, everybody looks at him. It's not a fault of that 8 years old boy. What are you expecting? 2 hours to sit there and we got to change that model. We have to take the kids out to some side room and put some color activity and all that. If we don't, then that kid who was told to shoo, he says, hell with your Hinduism, I don't give a damn to you. We should have a Balmiya, Sunday schools, a must. Every Mandir should have it, otherwise it's not a Mandir. We should have a yoga, Bharatanatyam, other cultural activities constantly ongoing. And we should have a reach out committee every Mandir where we reach out to others. So ending, thank you for listening this long, I heard so long. Finally, I'm summarizing everything what I shared in the book. As I told you, I'm more excited that in the back pages there are good comments from all others. So it's really, really nice. Summarizing what I told you, interfaith marriage is a part of our life. Accept it. Learn to religion. Recognize the religious fanatic. Christians and Muslims are not bad. It's a fanatic is something your problem. So that's what learn who is fanatic and who is not and what you want. It's, you have to decide what is right and wrong for you. It's your decision. I would say that it's probably no BBS, it's a good mantra for you. It's easy to convince your child. It's insurance against religious fanatic. And Now you are the ambassadors for Advent, whatever, whoever came, because you spend, you care for it. Now I expect each of you to go out and be ambassador. Don't be sick, timid, and forget about this thing. Go out and spread the message, and the message should go out all over. Again, we are not taking over, taking anybody's beliefs and all that. We want to respect everybody. We are pluralists. We want others to teach pluralism and in true sense, in marriage. Thank you very much.